Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's now discuss the connection between hybridization and charge stabilization. So we have three acid-base reactions shown on the screen. In the top case, we have a nitrogen with a positive charge. And as we go to the right, this acts as an acid, and the base plucks off the proton, and we get this neutral nitrogen with its lone pair. The exact same thing happens in the next two reactions. We have a nitrogen plus that loses a proton and gives a neutral nitrogen. And again, nitrogen plus goes to a neutral nitrogen. So in all these cases, we have the same atom that bears the charge, has the same electronegativity, has the same size. You could draw some resonance here, but they wouldn't be very good resonance contributors, so resonance is not part of the discussion. There is really not an inductive effect present here. So you would think all three of these acids on the left-hand side should have about the same pKa. Well, they don't. They have very different pKas. The top one has a pKa of a 10, the middle one is around 5, and the bottommost one is around negative 5. So this is the top one is our weakest acid, and the bottom one is, by quite a bit, our strongest acid. So if we can't explain this through size or electronegativity, resonance, or the inductive effect, how can we explain it? Well, as it turns out, the nitrogens in all these molecules have different hybridizations. And I've shown this on our far right. The top case has an sp3 hybridization, middle is sp2, and the bottom is sp hybridized. So how can we use hybridization to explain our trend in acidity? Well, we're actually going to look at the conjugate bases. We're going to look towards the right-hand half of the screen. So this nitrogen lone pair on the top example, this is sp3 hybridized, and I've tried to draw that kind of big and elongated because it's sp3 hybridized. It's about 75% p character in that hybrid orbital. This middle structure is going to be a little bit shorter and squattier because it's sp2 hybridized. It's two-thirds p character, about 67%. In the bottom case, it's sp hybridized, really short and squatty orbital. It's only 50% p character, sp hybridized. And people use this hybridization trend to explain the fact that the sp hybridized lone pair is not as extended, it's not as available to interact with the hydrogen. So therefore, this arrow, this equilibrium arrow, which I've poorly drawn going backwards, this equilibrium actually favors the right-hand side. So we are going to drive this reaction to the right because protonation of this nitrogen gives this kind of weakened orbital, this not very good nitrogen-hydrogen orbital. So we favor the right. So you would say this conjugate base is the weakest. It doesn't want to get protonated. And if it does get protonated, it gives rise to a very strong acid. Let's go to the top example. 75% p character, nice and elongated orbital, interacts well with the hydrogen. And so this acts as the strongest of the three bases. It wants to pick up that proton. And therefore, the related acid is the weakest of the acids. And we see that in the pKa. So we can use hybridization of these nitrogens, and you normally encounter this in nitrogens. More hybridized nitrogens are more basic and tend to form weaker acids once protonated.